I should probably save. Oh, we got codex entries too, apparently. Weapons locker. Shep. Let's see. Okay, so I've got an assault rifle, a shout gun, a snipper, a pistol, and my heavy. Right, let's see, I've got three options for this stuff. What the fuck? Holy shit, they actually have different models in the game now. That's great. Well, how the hell am I supposed to know what any of this shit is? Like, it doesn't have stats listed, is what I mean. Like, that's basic. Organic components clearly set it apart. Medium range semi-automatic rifle. Oh, it's gotta be semi-automatic. Oh, it's a heavy rifle. Okay. Eviscerator. Oh, great. Ooh, that actually looks like a Geth weapon. So that's pretty cool to see that they have different models now. So, oh my goodness, what the hell? It's a police rifle. I was gonna mention something about the yellow and blue paint. I was gonna make a Planet Side 2 reference, but I didn't know if I should. I guess I technically did now. Okay. I said, what the fuck is that thing? Heavy pistol. I'll stick with what I've got because it doesn't look like shit. Okay, and then we got three options here. Grenade launcher, which was fun to use. We got the Blackstorm Singularity Projector. And then the Arc Projector. Black hole gun. Black hole gun! So Jacob set up with a shotgun and a pistol. I guess he's automatically using that shit. Wait, what? I guess she has to use that one. Or I guess she only uses pistols. Okay.
Commander, you've received a new message at your private terminal.
Okay. No new messages. Excuse me. You lied to me. Oh my god, deck one, captain's cabin. What? Crew's quarters and engineering? Let's go to the freaking captain's cabin.
What's this area of the ship?
Oh, I don't know.
This is the commanding officer's quarters.
It's larger than the quarters of other warships I've served on.
This is a Cerberus vessel, not an Alliance warship. Accommodations have been made for personal taste. That said, this space is directly under the exterior pressure hull. The fitting yard workers called it the loft.
The loft. Medal of Honor. Oh, okay, that's just like what's downstairs. down below. Missing in action. The fuck is this? Save your crew from an overwhelming attack. Return to active duty. I guess these are like achievements. Or something. Fuck's on my little laptop? Oh, it's just little things. I've got a model Normandy, because why not? Sound system? Select music. Fuck that. Armor? Oh, that's the customization thing. Now, I was told the second time I see this, I should be able to use it. So, if I open this and there's spoilers, then it's not my fault. No helmet? Holy good lord. Cerberus assault armor? That actually doesn't look too bad. That looks awful. That looks awful. That's not too bad looking. Wait a minute. Is this a Dragon Age reference? I feel like that's what that's supposed to be. And that's probably why it looks shit. Okay, now, no helmet? Oh, no helmet or helmet. Or... Now, is this in combat? Because I don't want to, like, be walking around with this fucking helmet on. I guess it doesn't matter. I can in seven helmet. Chest plate. Oh, I get one or two. Well, wait, what the fuck? Yeah, we're using this because it's got glowy blue bits. So fuck you. Shoulders. Wait a minute. They're all the same pieces. It's of that one type of armor. It said it was best to mix with other armors. Material. What the fuck? What the fuck? No, I'm kidding. I don't know if this makes a difference in, like, battle. No, I don't want a pattern. Oh, wait, maybe. If I can choose pattern color. So is this stuff purely cosmetic, or is this, does this actually have stats? Yeah, I want the, this, type. Oh no, that's like, yeah. Achievement update. Oh, I see, what the fuck is that supposed to be? I can look like a doctor, I guess. What the hell is this? I'm a prisoner, I guess. No, I'll keep this base casual appearance. I don't know if any of the other ones really look. That one's not too bad. That one looks professional. But I don't want to look professional. I want to look militaristic. Too bad I can't have a beard. Okay, now... Is that everything that's in here? No, these are metals. So, oh, wait. Yeah, okay, so this is just... Oh, it says achievements right there in big bold letters up in the top left. Personalize your armor in your quarters on the Normandy. Oh, my God. Holy shit. Why do I have a picture of the rapist? That usually you don't have pictures of rapists on your desk. in your personal quarters. Excuse me, door! Okay. Crew's quarters. Ouch. Crew dick. Oh god.
Shepard, the men's restroom is on the port side of the ship.
Oops.
The starboard observation deck is closed until needed.
Great.
Oh, she's a cutie. How old?
She'll be a year old next month.
Oh, you'll miss her first birthday.
Well, my family lives in New Canton.
That colony's on the edge of the frontier. Could be vulnerable to collector attack, couldn't it?
Exactly. It's most important that she have a first birthday. That's why I'm here.
That's depressing. There's that big metal-looking ball thing again.
Access to life support is restricted. The port observation deck is closed until needed.
It's the same fucking bathroom, just opposite. Yeah, this would be kind of tight and cramped in here if you were taking a shower. I'll just stand over here in the corner. Ugh. You get a whole one sink and two toilets, and not much privacy for the toilets. Great. Medical lab. Oh, hey, I remember this. Caden stood over here.
Chef surprise again. Come on, Rupert.
I'm sorry, Princess. Filet mignon and caviar coming right up. Let me just get out my doilies.
That'd be real nice, Mr. Gardner.
Mess Sergeant Gardner.
Commander Shepard, the hero of the Citadel. You did humanity proud that day. Mess Sergeant Rupert Gardner here. How can I be of service?
Do you have everything you need?
I make do, but have you ever tried to prepare a decent meal with military provisions? I'm good, but I'm no miracle worker. Taking down the collectors is going to be rough business. The crew deserves a few fine meals before they throw themselves into the fire.
What do you need?
If I had some quality ingredients... Oh, shit.
Shit.
You've got more to worry about than grocery shopping on the Citadel. Forget I mentioned it.
If I head that way, I'll keep an eye out.
Much appreciated. Most of this list is probably standard fare for those namby-pambies on the Citadel. Anything else you'd like to talk about?
What do you do here on the Normandy?
What don't I do? Most think of me as the ship's cook, but I'm also the facilities technician and custodian. HVAC, plumbing, non-mission critical electrical. I make sure they're all clean and running.
So the man cleaning the toilets is also preparing the meal.
I wash my hands. Most of the time. This ain't no luxury liner. You have to pull your own weight in a Cerberus vessel. And I catch what falls through the cracks.
So to speak.
Through the cracks.
Fuck off, dude.
How do you feel about working for Cerberus?
Damn proud. Cerberus gets the job done. The Alliance and Council have got their heads buried so deep up their butt puckers they can't see squat. It'll take good old human ingenuity to crush these collector vermin. Only Cerberus knows that.
That's a new term.
How did you find your way into Cerberus?
Can you believe I was once a family man, working the Ezo rigs along the frontier? I was happy enough. But losing everything to Batarian raiders can change your outlook. I needed to make a difference. I'm no soldier, but I've got skills, and Cerberus keeps an eye out for talent. I'll do whatever it takes to help. Be that plumbing a sewer, routing an air duct, or keeping everyone's bellies full.
I won't take any more of your time.
Back to work.
You know, I don't know if you guys remember, but in the last, in the first Mass Effect Let's Play that I did, there was a moment, like, in the later half of the series where I had a bad, like, mouth sore, and it was really hard to do videos. I have a mouth sore again. This time, though, it's not in a bad place. The reason it was so bad last time was because it was in the worst fucking possible spot in my mouth. This one's totally just away.
What's this area of the ship?
I just thought that was ironic.
The sick bay. It is equipped to provide short-term emergency care. In the event of critical injury, personnel must be transferred to a fully equipped medical facility.
Actually, I think you'll find it's called the med bay, not the sick bay. But whatever you say, robot lady. Oh,
Commander,
look who it
Shepherd.
Is!
I watched the Normandy crumble with you on board. It's good to see you alive.
I'm shocked. You're serving on a Cerberus vessel now?
Surprising, even to me. Yet, here I am. The kind of trauma you endured would have changed most people. But not you, I see. Welcome back, Shepherd.
Do you have everything you need?
I believe so. This medical bay seems very much like the sick bay on the original Normandy. Only thing missing are my private reserves. I even had a bottle of Ceres Ice Brandy that I was saving for a special occasion.
I'll keep an eye out for a replacement bottle.
Quests!
Oh, you needn't. It's expensive, and we have much larger concerns ahead.
Yeah, like cleaning my spectacles quick. Put that down there.
Doctor, you've been with the Alliance for years. Why leave now?
After the Normandy was lost, the surviving crew was reassigned. I was stationed at the Mars Naval Medical Center, a very respectable position, but it wasn't on a starship.
You wanted to be on a starship.
Colonial military life isn't for you?
I've spent most of my life on warships, never knowing what the next mission might bring. I'm used to the hum of engines, the creaking of bulkheads, that subtle vertigo when the momentum dampeners kick in.
You mean...
Life planetside is just too static. Too boring.
That subtle feeling of, oh shit, I'm about to vomit. Yeah, oh boy, I love those too.
You're not the Cerberus type, Doctor.
I don't work for Cerberus. I work for you.
True.
On a mission that may be crucial to the survival of the human race. I have faith that your dealings with Cerberus will be ethical. I trust you, Commander.
I trust there's going to be some backstabbing at some point in this game.
There's a very good chance this mission will be a one-way trip. Are you prepared for that?
I've been through the reclaiming of Shanxi, the Skillian Blitz. We survived the Battle of the Citadel and the destruction of the Normandy together.
Yeah,
I've lived a full life. No regrets. I'd like to make sure the crew gets the same opportunity.
I guess we're kind of hard asses here.
I'll see you later, Doctor.
Commander.
Did that update my journal? Yes. Okay. So I've got a new little mini quest, I guess.
Access to the AI core is restricted.
Access denied. This way it looks locked, so I'm gonna go that way first. Main battery.
A gunnery officer is required to access the gunnery control station.
Well, it says main battery, but it's only when I look at that, so, okay. Oh, this is just when she said gunnery control station. I didn't know if I was looking at the wrong thing or something. What do we have over here? Normandy! Miranda's office. Boring office.
Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
No doubt you've got a lot of questions. Cerberus isn't as evil as most people believe. If I can help allay any of your concerns, I'd be happy to do so. So, what would you like to know?
I know what we're doing here, but what's Cerberus's long-term goal?
The advancement of the human race. Nothing more, nothing less. The Salarians have the Special Tasks Group. The Asari have their legendary commandos for stealth and recon operations. Cerberus is humanity's answer to those organizations.
She has a lazy eye, and I like that because I've got a lazy eye.
But those organizations are regulated by governments. Who keeps Cerberus in check?
Nobody. We're privately funded, and our backers trust the elusive man to make the right decisions. But he's very clear about our goals. Protect humanity and serve its advancement.
Are you military or political? Or both?
Cerberus has several divisions. Political, military, scientific. But we're all working towards the same goal. The teams you encountered before your accident were mostly part of our military division. But not all Cerberus operations use the same protocols. We try not to get bogged down in bureaucracy or formality.
Tell me about yourself, Miranda.
Well, I guess that's fair. I've spent the last 2 years learning everything there is to know about you. Well, you should probably know that I've had extensive genetic modification. Not my decision, but I make the most of it. It's one of the reasons the elusive man handpicked me. I'm very good at just about anything I choose to do.
You're cocky.
What level of genetic modification are we talking about?
It's very thorough. Physically, I'm superior in many ways. I heal quickly, and I'll likely live half again as long as the average human. My biotic abilities are also very advanced. For a human. Add to that some of the best training and education money can buy, and... well, it's pretty impressive, really.
So you're perfect.
Sounds like you were designed to be perfect.
Maybe. But I'm not. I'm still human, Shepard. I make mistakes like everyone else. And when I do, the consequences are severe. Everyone expects a lot from someone with my... abilities.
You certainly don't lack for confidence.
It's just a fact. My reflexes, my strength, even my looks, they're all designed to give me an edge. No point in hiding from it. It's the reason I'm trusted to oversee the most dangerous, risky, and technically demanding operations Cerberus undertakes. And it's why I was assigned to you. It's my job to make sure you succeed, Shepard.
Thanks for the information, Miranda.
No!
I'll talk to you later.
There's more to talk about.
Of course, Commander. Whatever you need. Commander, what can I do for you?
You have a minute, Miranda?
There's a lot to do, Shepard. Maybe another time.
Shit, I done fucked it up.
Anything I should know regarding the Normandy?
The crew's working well, and the ship appears to be performing to specifications.
What exactly are your duties, aside from keeping an eye on me?
I'm the elusive man's agent. You're his most important asset. My job is to make sure you succeed. Aside from that, I send regular reports to the elusive man, updating our status.
I'll let you work.
Of course, Commander.
Damn it. Got anything hidden I can poke around in back here, like your bed? Not a bad quarters, actually. I mean, it looks kind of cozy. The bed's a little in an area I wouldn't like. Although I guess it's better for two people. I prefer to have a bed that's against the wall. And I don't feel as exposed. Okay, I think we searched everything in here. So, you know what that means. Oh wait, no, wait. I think there's still actually a... yeah, engineering. We didn't go here yet.
What's this area of the ship?
Normandy's cargo deck. It includes facilities to rearm and repair Normandy's embarked ground vehicle and shuttle.
My last ship didn't need a shuttle. Why do we have one?
This ship is nearly twice the mass of the previous Normandy.
Oh.
It is more difficult to land the ship on high gravity worlds.
It's twice the size of the first Normandy. Okay. Yeah, that'll do it. No, it said air and ground. Shuttle and ground. I don't see any ground vehicles, so I feel lied to. Elevator. What the fuck?
Access to this room is currently restricted.
And access to that room is currently restricted too, I guess. Okay, let's go down here. Oh, we get to go into the internal bits. This looks like a companion would stand down here in this area. So, one of our crew members. I guess somebody I can recruit later.
You came all the way down here to see us?
To see us?
You're speaking to our commanding officer.
Shape up.
I'm touring the ship, getting to know my crew.
I'm Engineer Ken Donnelly, handling the power control systems. This is Gabby.
That's Engineer Gabriella Daniels, actually. I'm responsible for the propulsion systems.
What can we do for you, Commander?
Are you set up okay down here?
We can't complain. I just wish it didn't take so long to calibrate the FBA arrays.
Kenneth, you're complaining.
What kind of problems are you having?
When they upgraded the Normandy design, they got a bit sloppy with the FBA couplings. I won't bore you with the tech, but there's an array of attenuators in the primary power transfer system that channels the field bleed.
Kenneth, you're boring the commander with tech. In short, if we had T6 FBA couplings installed, it'd save us a lot of maintenance time each day.
Why isn't something like that already installed?
It's probably just a design oversight. Efficiency isn't affected, it's a maintenance issue.
Also, the T6 model can be hard to find. Nash and Stellar Dynamics discontinued them.
We could probably find used ones in the Omega markets, but we have no time for shore leave.
I guess I have to find one.
Where did you receive your training?
Both Gabby and I started in the Alliance, serving on the SSV Perugia.
She flew in the first wave at the Battle of the Citadel. We saw Sovereign firsthand.
I guess it didn't get destroyed.
Why did you leave the Perugia?
After you died, Anderson lost political clout. The Council backslid on the Reaper menace.
They discounted Sovereign as an isolated threat, as a single...
Which was bullshit. They said your warnings of a greater danger were mistaken or delusional.
We lost respect for Alliance leadership. We need to fight the real enemy, and only Cerberus seemed to be doing that.
Or I meant... Why isn't... Why the fuck would they just suddenly be like... I mean... I mean, I understand, but... I thought the Alliance would be the last ones to do the backsliding.
How did you wind up with Cerberus, Ken?
Once you were gone, the Alliance brass descended like vultures, tearing apart everything you'd said. I was very public with my defense for you. I didn't hold back...
That's an understatement. If Kenneth wasn't such a talented engineer, they'd have court-martialed him for insubordination.
But it got me noticed by the elusive man. He made an offer, and here I am.
So why did you join, Gabby?
Kenneth and I have been partners in crime since we graduated from Tech Academy. When he got the Cerberus offer, I insisted that it include me. They'd fall apart without me.
Thanks, Mum.
Also,
thanks, Mum.
Engines, and the Normandy is state-of-the-art. When I got the opportunity to work on her, I had to jump.
What do you think about Cerberus?
Actually, we don't know much about the organization other than the Normandy team. We know our mission and who's in charge.
We're off to kick the collectors right in their daddy bags. That's enough for me.
Carry on.
Will do, Commander.
Yeah, fine couplings, I was gonna say. Okay.
I'm amazed Shepard came down to see us.
I told you he would.
What's this area of the ship?
This is main engineering, which contains the ship's main fusion plant and Mass Effect core.
Oh, that's what this big giant bulbous over here is. This suit room does not look safe to stand in. Okay, so we have now effectively searched everywhere. Okay, now.
No messages for you, Commander.
Oh, okay. Is it a lie this time? No, okay. Let's see, so we've got assignments, which would be like my secondary objectives. We've got Normandy couplings. Yeah, find that. Service ice brandy, yeah. Or Ceres, no, why did I say service? Find ingredients. Overlord. Oh, this is stuff I must have gotten from my email. Yeah. I want to go to the Normandy crash site. But I'll probably do that in a little bit. Stop the collectors. It's my main mission. Dossier the Master Thief. Dossier the Veteran. Oh, are these... Are these of people that... Yeah, these must be, like, the different crew that I can or different, like, companions I can try to... What the fuck am I trying to say? I can recruit. There you go. Citadel of the Council. I'll go to the Citadel. Yeah, and Miranda recommended that I do the Solarian first, which would be this one. I think. Okay, we got new primary.
The system's
alive. Oh, here we go.
With elaborate secrecy, Cerberus labored for years to build a new superior Normandy. The vehicle's many alterations produced a craft nearly double the original size, requiring an even larger Tantalus drive core to compensate. The new Normandy features greater space in living quarters, research laboratory, observation deck, and cargo bay. Its shuttle can make landings the Normandy cannot attempt. In addition to tight beam communicators, Normandy's quantum entanglement communicator, QEC, provides instantaneous contact with the elusive man. The enhanced defense intelligence AI coordinates many of the ship's combat functions, assisting and even supplanting human piloting. Potential upgrades are numerous. The airframe could support additional armor and an axial mass accelerator. The thrusters could support recent advances in fuel technology beyond H2O2 chemical rockets. And the hull can mount double the standard number of kinetic barrier projectors, leaving space for stronger shields, easily sustainable via the new ESO drive core.
So it's the SR2, so the Normandy 2. I didn't know it was much larger.
The system's with elaborate secrecy, the system's Alliance UT-47 drop shuttle landing craft holds 12 soldiers in a cramped, uncomfortable cargo bay and two more in the cockpit. Officially named the Kodiak, the drop shuttle is better known to Alliance Marines as the Combat Cockroach due to its appearance and durability. The vehicle's robust environmental sealant technology exposes few vulnerable parts to the elements. First tested in the sulfuric acid clouds and extreme temperatures of Venus, the Kodiak can land in hard vacuum, high pressure, and temperatures from near absolute zero to over 900 degrees Celsius.
What?
A true contragravitic vehicle, the Kodiak's substantial element zero core allows flight by entirely countering the vehicle's mass. Its small thrusters are for directional control only. So if the mass effect field fails, the vehicle becomes a proverbial 3 million credit coffin. The unarmed shuttle forgoes weaponry space for active masking, electronic countermeasures, and a robust kinetic barrier system, ideal for dropping troops undetected.
Pursuit tactics. Dependent on light, sensors cannot detect objects moving faster than light speeds. No ship can be detected in interstellar ranges. Detection at interplanetary ranges from... Light speed lag. Observers see ships not when they appear, but where they were when the light bearing their image left them, minutes, hours, or days before. To counteract light speed lag, battle fleets surround themselves with spheres of screening and scouting frigates. Pursuers cannot detect ships and directly intercept them. Instead, pursuers track where objects were, where they were heading, and at what speed they were moving. Such data reliably predicts an object's future location and for pursuit along its light-lagged wake. Ships trying to evade pursuit follow erratic zigzag courses, requiring pursuers to make stops to update their projections. Haptic Adaptive Interface. Advances in computing have done away with traditional input devices like keyboards, damn it! Instead, modern input peripherals are usually holographically displayed in front of the user at a height and angle. Oh, okay, so they wear gloves. It's usually accepted motion accelerators, gloves, hands, location, control of the computer itself. So it presses against the holographic field force feedback. The glove kicks in, can be slight resistance. Simple toggle switch on the back of the hands allows the gloves to be turned off when not in use. Haptic interfaces have become so common that some individuals undergo cybernetic enhancement surgery to have those implanted in their fingertips. Going bare skin is the sign of a committed computer user. Shit, I wouldn't have those. Who no longer has to fuss with putting on gloves or cleaning them with alcohol wipes to get rid of the clammy hand smell. Oh, I was gonna say, what's so bad about putting gloves on all the time? But I guess you got the other thing. Security mechs. Sucks that they don't have pictures for this.